1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Sure nice to see you again. Today, John Fix and I are pretty excited. We found three nice PEXTO tools to add to our collection. And we're going to take all those three tools and refinish them today to get them looking sharp. And then we're going to build a display out of PEXTO. So let's get down to the shop and see what's going on.
It was a recent wonderful find, one of my favorites, a PEXTO screwdriver. This one has seen some rough use. You can see the deep scarring on here on the wood. And the handle's on here tight, but the wood's in really rough shape because of all these gouges on it. This one is I don't know if it was an early model, because they did do a PEXTO logo, and all the other tools I have the PEXTO name and an oval. This one just has PEXTO stamped on this area here, which are grips for putting a wrench on it and turning the screwdriver. The tip is in fairly good shape. It's been ground down some, but the shaft is straight. The metal is pitted in patina, of course, along with the sides chattered and rough. The back end, of course, has been banged on, and just lots of patina and age on this tool. The wood needing a complete sand down and restoration, which we'll do. This will be a beauty when it's ready. It'll be a nice addition to my PEXTO collection. I've got several other tools I'm going to finish very soon, and when I do, I'll be able to put up a nice PEXTO collection on the wall, which I've been wanting to do for a while. I've grown the collection a lot lately, so it'll make a very nice display. So we'll get on with the restoration. Well, I spoke to our video editing manager and staff, and they did a bad job by not getting me any before video on the two wrenches, so I'll have to shape them up, or tell them to get it right or get out. From now on, we want it right. Anyway, it's good to have what I do have. I was able to piece together some pictures, the before pictures, so we can make some comparisons on the tools. First, this little nice little monkey wrench was in the rough shape, and metal was badly discolored and scratched and some pitting, and of course the wood handle was in not a good shape at all. So here's what we did, and we managed to get a nice finish on this one. The wood, of course, is all restored, the metal all the way around, and we went with a matte finish on this. We didn't go with a high shiny finish. Just looked right for the little tool. Plus, there was no way to get this apart. And I guess there was a way, but would have been sort of destructive at this point. So we cleaned it up as best we could, and we got a nice little small wrench. You can see the PS&W company, which is PEXTO and Wilcox. And that was the name. This was patented January 24th, 1906. And you can see the logo up here, PS&W. Now, that was the name before they changed it to PEXTO. So I've got a few tools with that on it, which just means they're older. And then in the 1920s, they came up with the PEXTO name in the oval, and continued on with that. So this means it's the early ones when it says PS&W, or it has the full name, PEXTO and Wilcox. Next was this large pipe wrench, or larger. It's actually 9 inches in length. And the finish was kind of muddy, scratched up, banged up. I wish I could have shown you more what it looked like, because it was pretty rough. But we got it refinished and used something a little different on here. I went with my special black paint I've been using, which gives a nice black, I call it a glow, kind of a light on the black color, not a deep black, and it gives it a kind of a glow to the metal, gives it a natural dark metal look. You can see how it looks all the way around. So the PEXTO name, you can see it here. There's the PEXTO in the oval, and then the Made in USA underneath. And that was used as the final logo that they used. And there's a small one over here, but it didn't come out very well. Very faint. Actually, it's a 10-inch wrench. I called it 9, but actually 10-inch. And lastly was the screwdriver, and I always enjoy the PEXTO screwdrivers. It's one of the best screwdrivers made as far as I'm concerned, as far as the build quality and the looks on it. It's got a great rating as far as I'm concerned. The wood was in really rough shape, the rivets, and then, of course, the metal on it really, really bad again. And believe me, it looked as dark as the picture looks here. And here's what we did for a final tool. First, we took all the metal, polished it and shined it all the way around. And the tips, you know, it was not bad, but it was pitted and banged a little on the end. Here it has the PEXTO name, just PEXTO, P-E-X-T-O. That's not in the oval. Later ones I have the PEXTO. Screwdrivers I have the PEXTO in the oval. So this was the interim when they went from PS&W to PEXTO, and then PEXTO in the logo. That's the trans, or the path they took to get the changes in. The wood all sanded down. Of course, we had to sand these sides and this end cap down because it was really rough. And did our typical finish on it. We put a gun stock on it, and then gave it two coats of lacquer in between. We buffed it with the steel wool to get it really smooth down. And then after the final coat of lacquer, again buffed it with the fine steel wool, and then waxed it with a wax to give it that final finish, which again, it's not the high shine, but it's a real nice, beautiful little glow to it. I think it makes the wood come out very nice. So that's our three PEXTO tools, which the reason I went and got three tools was because I didn't have the wrenches. I had a screwdriver before. And I wanted to get a variety because I'm putting up a new PEXTO display, which I'll show you now. Okay, as I explained before, I'm updating all my displays, grouping tools by manufacturer and or type of tool. And before I get much into the display, let me clear up a couple of things. PEXTO and Wilcox Company was established in 1870, 150 years ago. And then later on, they changed it to PS&W Company. Then they changed it to the PEXTO name, which is the name without, you know, not in the oval. And finally, in 1915, they came up with the PEXTO logo in the oval, which they used on tools from moving forward. Pleased to get this display, and one thing to notice about it is there's such a variety of tools. They made planes, really nice plane. I've used, cleaned this one up, restored it, and used it. Hammers, pliers, wrenches, screwdrivers, snips, clamps, and that's not all. They've got drills and other items too. So they made really a wide variety of tools, more than most manufacturers. On this one we have, again, I mentioned the nice restored planer, the gas pliers, the pipe wrench, a small pipe wrench with the wooden handle, the monkey wrench with the wooden handle. Here's a couple of the linesman pliers, the nice, well-made ball peen hammer. That great clamp, the way they used to make them with a lot of style to them. I really like this one. This was patented in 1888. And of course, I showed you these snips in an earlier video when I restored them and how they worked. And that gorgeous screwdriver kind of rounds it out. So PEXTO makes for a nice display because they've got such a nice variety and nice looking and well-made tools. Proud to have them as part of my collection. Thanks for watching my video.